My personal role with Third Frontier was back in 1999, I was traveling around the state with the Farmland Preservation Task Force, and I smelled a rot in Ohio. Mm-hmm. Columbus was doing very well. Columbus is this bubble when it comes to economic development because of Ohio State, state capital, and all that other stuff. But yet there was this rot going on. So I got legislation passed through my own committee at the mm-hmm. time that established the Joint Select Committee to look at the impact of high technology on small business. The title of the report was something like Ohio and the Emerging Third Frontier. Mm-hmm. That was the basis then that Taft used then to go ahead mm-hmm. and form the whole Third Frontier thing. But what I'm hearing from you is that we've engaged a little bit in program drift.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And, you know, the first 2 years of Third Frontier, we made mistakes as a whole state. We went the wrong way. We quickly corrected. We started creating right centers of innovation.
Yeah.
IDCAS, again, is a great model of one that has worked extremely well. And part of it was this whole idea of this collaborative space. Another was the operating money we got.
Yeah.
This group of professors and people at AFRL said, okay, we're not going to take that money, take it back to our campus and pay for some students and stuff like that mm-hmm. on our projects. Mm-hmm. Instead, we took most of our operating money and had it matched by companies who wanted that money, who were going to move in here and do their acceleration as a company inside IDCAS or in Dayton.
Okay.
And we were able to leverage that money and our facilities and help those companies run out into products. And there's some that went out pretty fast. There's others like a Tracer Diagnostics that's moved out of the tech area on Kenner Road and moved downtown now. They've got their own facility, building their own facility. They're on their way. And that was all because IDCAS's involvement in the very beginning. Those are the kinds of things that we can do if the money is there from Third Frontier or some other, maybe it's the Jobs Ohio or whatever it comes from, that allows us to build those kinds of technologies and markets.
We need to have you get into a room with some of my friends at Jobs Ohio. Well, this has been Gene Krebs on behalf of the Center for Community Solutions. We've been having a wonderful series of conversations here with my good, dear, pre-political friend and still very good, close friend, Dr. Gil Pacey, formerly of Miami University, where he could easily have retired on his 31 years of service. But instead, no, he's now at University of Dayton, a private school. And engaged in this stuff, basically because I think you have a burning desire to make Ohio a better place, even though you are a native of Illinois.
That's correct.
Which I will not hold against you, which I purposely chose not to mispronunciate the state like we all do and call it Illinois.
Yeah.
The S is silent. The S is silent. All right. But thank God you're not silent.
That's right.
All right. This has been Gene Krebs. Thank you very much, and we'll see you next week.